that happened sometime back at my place. What happened there, so this driver came and he couldn't make a judgment about the soil condition and his load, and he tried to unload the load and it got stuck. And then like 2-3 people, 4-5 hours spent to take it out, but couldn't, like they jacked and they do various things to move it, but they dig holes, nothing worked. So finally we had to get other excavator and unload the load and then give a little push to the truck, so then we could release it. So the motivation here, most of us jumping to things by just looking at the appearance, just making the judgment by looking at how it is. So you jump into relationship by just looking at how he or she looks like. So as IT people, the most of us that's tech lead or architects, we jump into projects by the claim from the BA on the DevOps team making about the environment or the requirement, right? So sometime we go and like start the project and we give our estimations. Hey, we were told, okay, you have this environment, that environment, you have production, you have UAT, you have a dev staging environment, and you just need to push your code to the GitHub and then it will automatically deploy, pipelines are set up, everything is cool. So you, for a moment, you feel like, wow, life is awesome. Everything is there. I just need to take care of my development team. But sometime when you're trying to deploy, your pipeline doesn't work. Why? Because it was not tested. Sometime your pipeline works, but when you keep deploying one by services to your cluster, the cluster suddenly stop. Why? Because cluster cannot scale. Something has happened. But end of the day, people question you why you fail, why you cannot deliver on time, why you cannot meet this deadline, right? Because end of the day, it's your fault because it is not because of you done something wrong, it is because you judge things by looking at its environment. In our case, so this driver may have asked how is the soil condition, right? He may just he was maybe lazy to come out and see the soil condition, right? Or he may didn't have any idea about his load, right? So end of the day, what happens is I had to bear the cost of this load and unloading charges and also the labor charges I had to bring to help him, right? And also I tipped the driver because the charges he might have pay maybe more than his daily wage, right? So yeah, it is his fault, but in other hand, it's our fault because we couldn't warn him regarding this wet soil condition, right? So it doesn't matter whose mistake is, but the problem is we could avoid this. So likewise, in our life, many cases, we can avoid the things by if we not judging things by its appearance. Don't judge the book by its cover. It's sometimes true, right? So do not ever judge or do estimation by just listening to what the BA has to say or what your DevOps team has to say, right? So just jump there and just do some little test and try to figure out if everything is fine. So at least if you cannot do that, sometime PM just say no, you don't have to do that. So that is already there and it has tested, it's their responsibility. If something comes, they are available. But the truth is, sometime you work on a weekend, sometime you work on overnight, right? So when you need, they are not available, right? But end of the day, again, the problem is you have to answer. So the lesson from this truck driver, do not ever jump to conclusion or make judgment if you don't have real detail about the environment. So if you don't have that, it's always better to play on safe side rather than failing. Small lesson, right? From a truck driver. Okay. Anyway, talk to you soon again. Stay safe. Take care. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe.